editorials. So we'll be discussing the what, why and how of the various articles and the perspectives and the dimensions which you get via these articles you can comprehensively address in your mains examination. And we shall also be discussing the various maps and mapping part which is helpful to you for your prelims examination. Hence, let's start the editorial analysis. So, the first article which we are going to discuss is the revival of tiger. Now, as you all people know, tiger conservation is a dominant aspect of Indian Wildlife Protection Act, which was passed in the year 1972. Now, it's not only a dominant part of tiger conservation, but what we can see is that the India's Corbett Tiger Reserve has multiplied its tiger population to many folds. Now, what do you mean by multiply? Why is this aspect important for us? Now, what we see is that tiger plays an important role in not only in India's environment but also in India's cultural aspects. So, when we come to the aspect of India's cultural aspect, what we can dominantly see is that even in the Harappa's and Mohenjo-daro, what we see, the dominantly even on the Pashupati seal, we can see the tiger being a dominant animal figure. Now, as we see, even on the Pashupati seal, the tiger is a dominant animal figure. Even what we can see is that the India's conservation program, not only is cultural oriented but also environmental oriented. Why? Because around India's tiger's population consists of around 84% of total world's population. It indicates India shelters around 84% of total tigers present across the world. Now, the tiger population growth has seen a enormous increase. Especially when we come to Corbett Tiger Reserve, the population has been seen, around 260 tigers have been found in the Corbett Tiger Reserve. And one of the dominant fact for prelims is that this has the highest density of wild tigers globally. Now, the highest density of wild tiger globally is found in Corbett Tiger Reserve. Now, particularly in prelims, there are questions been asked which state or which tiger reserve has highest number of population and which tiger reserve has highest number of density. Now, when the question comes around highest number of density, your answer should be Corbett Tiger Reserve. And which tiger reserve has highest amount of population, let me know in the comment section below. Now, what we see is that the rich and diverse aspect of India's heritage now is reflected towards tiger and tiger reserve. Now, there is a concept called as ecotourism, in which we also consider the various villages surrounding around the tiger reserve into consideration. This is not only provide various employment opportunities, but it also provides a decent social capital. And the traditional village practices of forest conservation plays an dominant role in understanding the tiger population and understanding the environment. Because before we jump into conservation, we should first understand what is the environment and what is the context all about. Now, the next aspect and the major concern is how do we bring the communities into engagement. Now, what we see is that community engagement plays a very important role. Now, the government had come with a policy of living with tigers. Now, living with tigers is a policy in which we provide a comprehensive tackling strategy that how to tackle with the tigers and make sure that tiger and human population are coexisting with each other rather than conflicting with each other. And there is an aspect known as beehive fencing, and it's also known as Corby honey is a project taken by local communities. Now, what is this beehive fencing all about? Now, what we see is that, let's think, this is an area of tiger reserve, and this is the area of villages, and this is the area of tiger reserves. Now, what we see is that the village is surrounded by a beehive fence. Now, when this beehive fence have been kept as a border check, what happens is that the moment the tiger tries to intrude in the village, these bees create a buzzing sound which is tend to be irritative to the wild animals such as tigers and elephants. Now, this Corbett Tiger Reserve is also known for its mythological significance, and it also tries to explore the deep cultural significance of the tiger. Now, what we see is that India has been launched in 1973. India has launched National Tiger Conservation Act. Under this act, a project was launched which was called as Project Tiger. Now, it had aimed to expansion of conservation efforts across various horizons of India, and it also gave rise to National Tiger Conservation Authority, and it was also given statutory powers to act accordingly. Now, there have also been introduced a program such as M Stripes. M Stripes is an app-based monitoring system which was launched by National Tiger Conservation Authority. Now, what we see is that this M Stripe plays a dominant role. It's also in PYQ question. In previous year, a question was asked with respect to M Stripes, that M Stripes is launched to conserve which of the following wild assets, which is nothing but tiger. So, I hope you dominantly understood the tiger conservation efforts. So, the Corbett National Park lies in Uttarakhand district, Uttarakhand state of India. Now, let's move to the next article of reshaping by AI. Now, this article, reshaping by AI, dominantly speaks about the artificial intelligence and its global conservation efforts. Now, what we see is that the AI is being dominantly influenced and being dominantly unregulated. Now, this unregulation of AI has caused various concerns and various challenges as such. Now, aftermath in 2023, we can see dominant AI based loopholes were created, in which deepfakes is a major consideration to be considered, and the civil unrest which was caused by deepfakes as such. Now, what we see is that they have been focusing on how to tackle AI and how to overcome this concerns of AI by using frontier technology. Now, considering all this, the article dominantly highlights on the efforts of United Nations in tackling AI. Now, United Nations in 2019 had brought a UN framework for AI. Now, this UN's AI policy has not only thought to build various aspect of need of normative and operational framework, but also it tried to focus on ethical framework and how ethics need to play a dominant role in regulating AI. Now, what happens is that when we try to implement this artificial intelligence, there is a concern called as digital sovereignty. Now, digital sovereignty is a concept in which every aspect, every country considered, every individual considered himself or herself to be digitally sovereign. Now, it's an aspect of confrontation of freedom of speech and expression. But the issues of AI such as hate speech, disinformation and false information play a major role. Now, one of the major concept of false information can be considered, as you all know that Ukraine President Zelensky's video was made in which he says that he will surrender all his Ukraine to Russia. Now this video was a result of deep fake. Now this deep fake was created based upon the platform using artificial intelligence. Now this is the major aspect which needs to be considered. And next is the digital empires and regulating models. What we see is that whenever we come to US and China are emerging into digital empires with their own digital regulatory models. Whenever we come to US, US model is approachable and China's model is deterrence or state driven. And this free model emphasizes on free speeches and China uses AI to deter the same. Now there are been contradictions in the geopolitical scenario since itself. Now even whenever we come to EU, EU's model is somewhat human centric model. Now what we see is that the global poles are creating a contradiction within itself. Now India's digital model, India's digital pillar is somewhat inclusive. Inclusive indicates India emphasizes on inclusive aspect of including everyone whenever it focuses on technology such as AI. Now there are various digital models. The concept of liberal democratic values and the dominance of capitalism and the dominance of socialism or communism. Now there have been contradictions around the world itself based upon which appropriate model should be considered. So this is the aspect. And why AI needs to be regulated? Because the growing concerns of geopolitical unrest across various domains, what we see is that there has been ethical considerations about autonomous machine learning tools. Now what do you mean this autonomous machine learning tools? This autonomous machine learning tools is on what basis do this AI based system make decisions. Now there are also aspects of control of digital lethal autonomous weapons. These weapons are fit and forget. Now fit and forget indicates once it has been launched, then based upon its own machine learning tools, the AI targets the destinations. So this is the concerns of these aspects. Now what we see is that when we see the global politics and the ethical challenges and the aspect of digital sovereignty, this all should come under a single plate, and India can play a dominant role in bridging the global south and the global north towards working out a comprehensive ethical framework. So let's move to the next article, why West enduring. Now what we see is that we are post World War II and post Cold War era. The world is seen to move towards US based international order. This article questions at what extent the US were able to successfully lead the world as such. As we can see, US leading the world, there have been China's issues in the South China Sea. And second aspect is the dominance of Russia over Ukraine. And the third most important aspect is that the ongoing West Asian geopolitical crisis with respect to Israel and Gaza, the Palestine issue. Now what we see is that all these tensions are concerns, are questioning the stability of US led international system. Now what we see is that these all aspects raises the questions of uncertainty of US led order in maintaining global leadership. Now, if we specifically assess the geopolitical trends, what we see is that the standoff in Ukraine, the Middle East hostilities, and China's assertiveness in the South China Sea, all these aspects challenge US-led global order, which suggests a political jeopardy of Western dominance. So, there is an aspect which the author highlights known as triumphalism. Now, what is this triumphalism? Triumphalism is an aspect where the Western loss or the Western's incapacity to rule, to focus on rule-based world order has been cautioned. Now, this triumphalism focuses on shifting global power dynamics in which every country try to assert its own influence is called as triumphalism. Now, what we see is that historically, the West was dominantly persisted despite its past discussions and downfall. The West still remained relevant, but not as relevant as pre-Cold War crisis. Now, whenever we come to the China and the Russian alliance pose a serious threat to Western domination, as China is globally addressing 24% of global manufacturing and it's also a dominant resource pool of semiconductors and critically rare earth minerals. Now, what we see is that even the rising of internal conflicts such within BRICS and tensions within non-Western institutions like SCO, challenges in presenting united front against West. Now, what we see is that even there is a West dominance, there is no united front from Asia or the East as such. Why is this united front not possible? Even though we have various organizations such as BRICS, such as SCO, there are various concerns going within themselves, which can't give a united counter or a united front to the aspect of Western dominance. Even the various decline in the G7's economic influence is decreasing, and the US dominance across the Western Asian is decreasing because China has recently brokered a deal of peace in between Iran and Saudi. Now, India, despite having a cordial relationship with West, even it realizes the importance of strategic cooperation with the West in navigating the conflict. Now, India also focuses on strategic autonomy, where it tried to question any major power led world order. Now, when this all US led global system has been questioned, considering the lasting impact and adaptability of West to geopolitical changes, India's focus on pragmatic strategy, which is also highlighted by our External Affairs Minister Jay Shankar, and which reflects the complexity of global power dynamics. So, India can play a vital role in leveraging this bridge between West and East by focusing on rule-based world order. So, I hope you got the various perspectives. In first article, we discussed the dominance and the importance of tiger conservation. And in the aspect of second article, we came to know the UN's EI regulation policy. And the third article, we comprehensively questioned the US-led world order. Thank you all. Hope you enjoyed these articles. Have a good day.